So why does the postcondition of square root fail? The answer is simple, yet not so simple. What we lack here is diagnostic information. We don't know the values of r or z or anything that happens in between. So what we do is we set up a framework that allows us to access these. So what we have set here is we have set up a try except block around the square root function, which catches the assertion. And when an assertion is being raised or any other kind of error is being raised, we print out the offending parameter r and we exit the loop. So let's see what happens here if we invoke the whole thing. So here's the bad value, 8,436.9207865. Wow, magic value. So why can't we just square this? What's wrong here? So we print out the value and now we go and actually square it and multiply it by itself. Let's see what we get. Again, we run the whole thing. R21.3.01753488, and this is 21.2.3.01753488. Well, by all means and measures, these two look identical to me. So why does the assertion above here fail? We can solve the mystery simply by looking at the actual difference between these two values. So let's see what the numerical difference is between the square root squared and the original value itself. Here comes another value which fails, 9049 dot something. And here, at the very end, you see the difference. It's 10 to the power of minus 12, meaning that 12 digits after the comma, we do have a difference between r and the square root of r squared. The reason why this assertion failed is simply a rounding error. The numbers are the same up to the 11th digit, but at the 12th digit, they actually are different. And this is why the assertion failed.